And here we go. The final map of tonight's pro scrim is about to begin. Complexity versus Curse. Complexity, they are on fire right now. They've won the past three maps thanks to who is my new MVP of the night, Clayster.
Yeah, Clay's been playing phenomenally. Now, that last Search and Destroy, though, we saw Crimsix and Aches go absolutely huge with 12 kills each, I believe.
I think 12 and 10.
12 and 10? All right. So they both went huge and went clutching in multiple rounds. But, you know, Clay on CTF and especially that huge raid hardpoint with that Stealth Chopper really has been coming up huge.
So Slums capture the flag. We all know that Complexity, they love Slums, and the past two CTFs in the series, Complexity, they've taken them pretty convincingly. 6-0 on standoff and 3-0. Actually, I think I had that wrong. 6-0 on raid.
Raid.
And 3-0 on standoff.
Yeah. And you know, it'll be interesting to see how everyone starts out here on CTF on Slums, because the beginning breakouts for this map really determine how the whole round plays. So I'm really going to be watching these beginning breakoffs.
So obviously Complexity's goal on this side, they want to go up by, you know, around three flags along with Scorching Control. And Curse's goal, they want to try to go in with a tie with also Scorching Control.
Yeah, and you want to get streaks, but that's not good for Curse because that's three down. And if Complexity can push and get control of their base, I mean, this is an easy cap.
And just like that, it's all to TP. Furthest one push up on the map will challenge through the middle. There is Complex, but he's doing a great job staying alive right now, keeping a good presence on the map for Complexity. This is going to allow his teammates to push up. They already retained mid-map control, and now they're going to be able to make another effective push.
Yeah, you know, right now, Complexity just has to, they have to play smart and just work for map control. And, you know, they kind of gave it up right there, letting Curse push three guys into ring, and that's going to be huge. And it looks like Curse is now going to push up and try and get a flag.
Yeah, Curse just got two cycles of kills right there, despite Complexity having the map control. They tried to really force the issue there, and they were punished. It's now Curse. That is three down and one off spawn for Complexity. Miracles finds one on the flag, and this might do it. Complex is going to go for a flagpole right now, but no smoke grenade. He's actually got a sniper out.
Yeah, that's interesting, you know, and that actually probably is going to, it's probably going to hurt them right now on this flag, to be honest. You'd love to have a smoke in this situation or, you know, something that can help you pull this flag out, because it's hard to kill these players from across.
But, flag acquired.
I mean, the sniper rifle really didn't come out to turn to bite them right there, but one player from Complexity has actually gotten to the cursed flag.
That is Teep, and they know about it now as he goes for the counter pull. Teep, he's got to make something happen. He finds one behind Blue. The kill has been made there by Miracles, but Ace is there to pick up the slack. Gonna go for the flagpole, but Twins does get their turn. Complex, he's gonna dive this one in. All four players dead for Complexity as Curse Gaming capture the first flag.
That's actually a huge play out of Curse Gaming here. To get a flag on this one spawn, it's extremely difficult to do. And, you know, right now with Complex running this sniper rifle, he's extremely close to streaks, you know, so he's gotta watch himself.
Finding one over near the Blue Jeeps, Crim does shut him down, but now you got Blindfire, and when Blindfire gets the hot hand, you gotta watch out for him.
Yeah, you know, when he gets hot and he has his AR controlling this middle of the map, it's extremely difficult to get past. And as we see on your mini map, you're going to see Complexity try and push this through this brick side. And Curse has to be careful not to turtle too much in their base and play too much defense, because that's going to afford Complexity to get an easy cap.
They just got to grind it out from this point on. Your main focus, especially when you're on the least favorite side here, get middle map control. Then you could play a little bit more turtly as you got the map positioning to work against Complexity.
Right, and the thing that I'm noticing out of the Curse players too is that we're seeing a lot of extreme conditioning out of them, and it's something that's kind of odd for Capture the Flag, because on Capture the Flag from most players we see tons of attack mask and dexterity, and you know, right now with the extreme conditioning they're pretty much just running laps on the map.
Yeah, and this is going to be another cap for Complexity. I don't see anybody for another flag cap for Curse, as I don't see anybody from Complexity in position to stop this. So this is like so good for Curse. Not only are they on the least favored side, they got two flag caps, and Complex is looking good to get score streaks here.
Yeah, you know, if he can get streaks, I mean, that would just be huge. Because, you know, going into the second half, up flags and score streak control, I mean, That wouldn't look good for Complexity at all, but you know, Crim kills him.
And all four dead.
That's all four dead, and they have that spawn lock with Clayster on cop car. So it'll be interesting to see if they can get these cutoffs and get this flag.
Yeah, it's looking like this will be a successful counter pull and counter cap from Complexity. Crimsix will put this in, but it's going to be Ake still in position. Finds one there on the Miracles, but he's immediately cleaned up. It will be Clayster. Not going to follow up the push, just wants to hold map control for the time being, but that's a big cap from Complexity.
Oh, yeah, that's a huge cap from Complexity. I mean, it's pretty much you needed at least one cap to go into the second half, because if you went into that second half down 2-0, it's going to be almost impossible to come back. You know, right now, with no score streaks for either team, going in down one flag to nothing isn't the end of the world, but you are making it extremely difficult on yourself.
Of course, Complexity, they would love to try to tie this game up with 50 seconds remaining. They're going to continue to ramp on the pressure towards the cursed base. Teep leads the way as he picks up one kill on a complex. So they're going to be fighting from the flank here, which is a bit of an awkward position, especially since you're giving Curse a spawn right on their flag.
And you know what? I like to play out of Complexity. You know, you see all four members of Curse playing defense. And, you know, they're just letting Complexity get into their base. And as we say, that's never good. And look, it's going to give up a flag cap because of it.
Yeah, Kram, he's going to try to run this one through. But wait a second. Miracles won't make a play happen as he takes out TP. So they're going to be flooding through the bricks and garage side of the map. Huge kill coming out of Clayster, getting that cut off middle map. So Complexity, they will tie this game up moving into the half. And you know they're definitely happy about that, but still Curse. You can't be that disappointed because this is your goal on that least favorite side.
No, if you're Curse, you can't be disappointed at all. But at the same time,
you're up two flags.
At the same time, you're up two flags, and I mean, the first one, I can understand giving up. You got all four down. It was just an unfortunate spawn. The second one, though, is the one that you absolutely cannot give up. You know, we say this time and time again. You can't turtle on CTF, and you know they pinched from both ways, kind of forced them to sit on their flag, and I mean they broke it pretty easily.
One thing I saw that was kind of weird from their classes was not only were they not using TAC masks, they really didn't have any smokes to try to initiate that pull. They did it all by just pure slaying power.
Yeah, you know, that's like something I like to call greedy classes. And for a game like CTF, you can have greedy classes. And right now we see Twiz actually, I believe he pulls out a smoke with Dead Silence. So this is an actually good class for, you know, CTF to get pulls, but it would have been good to have that last game with smoke.
Yeah, with putting on Dead Silence on your class for CTF, that just means you want to be a sneaky baby. You want to try to sneak around the map and a smoke grenade.
No.
Well, that's going to give you the cover to do so. So we'll keep an eye on Twiz. But wait a second. It's Crimson trying to make a play happen at the curse base. He's in a great position to go for a flagpole, but I think they know something's up. He's going to find one. There goes Blindfire, but Twiz is around the area. And Crimp, he doesn't have the luxury of trying to hear Twiz through his headset, so Twiz will sneak through, does pick up that kill, and the flag return. But now Curse, in the back of their mind, they're going to be like, how did Crimson sneak through like that?
Yeah,
they got to rotate back and clear out our base.
Yeah, they're going to have to rotate back and clear out their base, but I think more of the underlining of what that flag pole did for Complexity was, it was forcing Curse to rotate back towards their base, which gave them mid-map control again.
And now Complexity, with mid-map control, they're going to try to get at least one cycle of kills and then go for a pull from there. But now Clayster, his job on the site, just hold blue. He's going to push as far out towards the blue Jeep. But really, Complexity, they're not a team that likes to flood all the way towards the white wall and try to flank around. They prefer to be aggressive through garage.
Yeah, that's where they prefer to be aggressive. And, you know, you see Complex with this sniper rifle again. And I don't know how big of a fan I am of this class on CTF, especially because CTF is such a team-oriented game. I'd like to see the classes used as a whole better.
I mean, I feel like the sniper, it'd be better if they were on the other side to try to pick off at a defender, you know, maybe at the back Jeeps, maybe at the back fountain. But when he was using the sniper, he was set up over near the back alley of garage where you don't really have the best line of sight or the cover to try to work with it there. So I'm a little bit intrigued.
I'm a little bit intrigued by their classes as well. And I was going to say before with the smoke is I would like to see the smoke on the other side and not as much on this side. I don't know how advantageous the smoke is on this side.
Yeah, if you're using it when you're pushing garage and you get a smoke on the enemy's flag, you could pull it in any direction you want to. You could even pull it towards the back fountain because they can't really see which direction you're going in
until that
initial kill sign pops over your head.
No, yeah, absolutely. I completely agree. I think the smoke would have been a lot better used on the other side. To be honest, they probably would have gotten an extra flag cap because we saw Complex being stuck in that back alley for a pretty long time.
And the one thing missing from this game, it's got to be score streaks. It looks like Miracles, he's starting to slow down his gameplay and really try to play for these streaks as he's on a 4-kill spree. But, you know, if any which team, Complexity or Curse, if they had streaks, it would make this second side a whole lot easier.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if one team had streaks right now, it would completely change the way both teams are going to play the second half. And right now, we're not really seeing anyone get good control of the map and really push up. And, I mean, right now, we're seeing a little mini push from Complexity forcing Curse to rotate two or three guys back. But we're not really seeing any really hard, good, aggressive pushes.
Yeah, for the most part, it's been just a scrappy battle near the middle of the map. You know, occasionally see one team forced to fight from their spawn. Now Teep, he's going to go for a flagpole, jumping through the big window. Great moves from him, but there are just too many Curse players behind him, and he's unable to escape with that flag. But still some good pressure being put on by Complexity. Now, with a minute 35 seconds left to play, let's look at our scoreboard. It looks like more kills, only a couple kills, though, going in favor of Curse.
Yeah, you know, right now, Curse has to be extremely careful because you can't get too over aggressive trying to get a cap, and especially from the side that they're on, and just give up a counter pretty easily. You know, you have to play pretty smart. And also from complexity, you can't play too defensive. And right now we're seeing three guys back at their base, which is pretty defensive.
Yeah, you saw what happened from Curse when they decided to turtle their base. Wasn't good news from them, but Clayster, he's going to run out of burst, so Miracles will live for the time being. But he does clean up the kill eventually. Now Clay on a three kill spree. A minute remaining until we go to overtime. I want to see him just really try to work for those streaks, but he gets taken out.
Yeah, that's what I would have liked to see there too. You know, I would have liked to see him really just start racking up kills mid-map and really work on the streaks. But if you notice on your mini-map, there's a member of Curse all the way behind Complex and the flag. And, you know, they have two guys on top of the flag, which it's never good to turtle your flag and see if it comes back to bite him.
Oh, Twist picks up two kills on the flag. Acquired. This might be it for Curse. You see that he's going to be running the flag towards blue. That's the support from one teammate. That's going to be Complex picking up the kill. But Aches does make one defensive kill. Can't pick up the second. It's Complex. He's going to try running away with this flag. But Crimson watching middle map does stop the flag for the time being. And he will get the return. Complexity, they hang on to their base. But here comes one last push from Curse.
I mean, that was just a huge kill from Crimson. I mean, if he gets that flag right by, that's game over right there.
All right, so that's going to force overtime. Let's take a look at our scoreboard heading into it. And, you know, I've said it, you know, kind of halfway into this round, but we have yet to see a score streak acquired in this game. Crimson, he's got a great start towards the Hellstrom, so he's around halfway there.
It's a draw. But stand down.
You saw Clayster in this position as well. You saw Miracles in this position. They didn't really decide to slow down and make their play style one so that they could really acquire those streaks.
Right, and I think you see that because Slum's such a difficult map to slow down your play style to play for streaks because it's so mid-map dominated that if you play a little slower and just give up a little bit of your position mid-map and you give them an extra guy in the middle, they're going to win that and get map control for the whole round, and you can't afford to give that up.
And now we're going to be starting things off with Complexity. They are back on the more favorite side, and Krim, he's the guy to watch as he's the closest to score streaks. And you see him using Tackmask, gets the first pick onto Complex, and now he's just going to be taking control of Blue, but still so close to some streaks. We'll find the kill. He is one kill away from getting the Hellstorm missile, which will help him out tremendously.
And if he gets this Hellstorm, that's huge for Complexity. And right now you're going to see them make an aggressive push down for the flag.
Find one more, picks up Miracles. He's fully streaked out, War Machine and everything. Trying to get this one away. It's going to be TP. Continuing to run his flag. No, another great defensive kill there coming from Complex. Now, Clayster. Complex is just cleaning up house at his base. Clayster looks like he will pick up one kill there on Miracles, but amazing defensive plays coming out of Complex. Now he's the player closest to streak.
Yeah, now they have to make sure they don't give Complex streaks because that would really just negate what just happened with Crimson, you know?
And Complex, if he gets the assist, even that'll give him some streaks. But he just wants to hang back, put himself in a nice, cozy head glitch, and wait for a Complexity player to come into his line of sight.
Yeah, you know, it'll be interesting because right now Complexity has mid map, and, you know, they already picks up his Lightning and his Hellstorm. So it'll be interesting to see how he uses these. Most likely, I think he's going to have to use them defensively because Curse is playing extremely, extremely defensive right now.
Yeah, right now they just want to waste as much time off the clock as possible in Complexity. They want to cap as quickly as they can on this side. So Complex knows one player going for a flank will clean up the kill there, and that is going to earn him the War Machine. So even streaks on both sides now.
Yeah, and it'll be interesting. It looks like Curse is making more of an aggressive play towards the middle of the map. And it'll be interesting to see if they try and get a flag cap on this side.
Well, do you think that they have an idea that Krim has streaks to use?
I don't think they have it. I don't think they know that Krim has streaks. I mean, I really don't think they have any clue because he's at
Hostile
about 3,400 points and he's only plus two. Yeah, now they have to know. If you're a Complexity, you probably know that Complex has streaks. He's 24-19 and he went on a huge spree at the base.
What if Complex stays alive on this push through garage and he uses a lightning strike off spawn? Now he's going to use a Hellstorm and so finds one on the Clayster, but Aches will pick up the final kill. So essentially, you know, a Hellstorm just flat out used by Complex. But if he stays alive at front garage, uses the lightning strike off spawn, that'll take out all the players near the back fountain and then they go for a pull.
No, absolutely. That's a perfect play. And, you know, Complex is just shredding right now. He picks up two and it'll be interesting to see if he's going to use this lightning. He's trying to get team members through bricks. You know, he's really holding us down all by himself right now. His team members really got to push up into bricks and help him at garage.
Yeah, he's a man on a mission right now as he's just hanging out near garage. His teammates not really in a position to give him some support. And he's going to get taken out, but I got to take a look at the scoreboard now. 28-22, caps, one return. Three returns coming from Twiz, but still, I mean, kind of even in terms of total kills from both teams. Maybe a couple more kills in favor of Curse.
Yeah, you know, you probably would have liked to see Curse get a little more aggressive on that garage right there. You know, Complex has streaks, and I mean, he was in garage slaying for a solid, I would say, 45 seconds to a minute almost. If you could have got guys over there with him, I think you probably could have gotten a flag.
So he finds Crimsix inside the blue corner, so they're going to be putting up another push here, but Clayster's alive on their base, and they don't have a Hellstorm missile to use. Only a Lightning Strike left, and I think he still has some of the War Machine to use as well. As Crim, he hasn't used any flag stopping score streaks, so yet he's just used a couple grenades out of the War Machine.
No, and to be honest, if Curse were to pull this flag, I wouldn't use any streaks right here, Revan, because I would save my streaks and use them offensively for the second half, and Slums is such a wide-open map that I think if you saved both your streaks, a Hellstorm and a Lightning for the second half, and I mean, you're playing from the less advantageous side, but there's really no cover to hide for those except for Laundry over there, and I think you can probably get a cap out pretty easily.
Yeah, Laundry, or you're forced to be aggressive inside the garage, in which case if you use your streaks, you know that's the play they're going to make. But Blindfire, he's going for a pull for Curse Gaming, but you see TP on the other side of the map is in a position to get the return here as Clayster does take out Complex. They are going to use a Hellstorm and a Lightning Strike here.
Yeah, that's an interesting play. You know, I'm not too big of a fan of that play. I probably would have saved those for next round.
But now here comes Complex. We'll call in a Lightning Strike of his own. So both teams kind of using all of their streaks. And in the end, Complex will get the return. And Blindfire is going to go for a capture. So both teams use all their streaks. And in the end, Curse Gaming, they cap the flag in 4 minutes, 30 seconds.
Yeah, you know, I'm surprised both teams used all those streaks. Yeah, I'm surprised. I'm pretty surprised Crim used his streaks right there. But, you know, 4 minutes and about 30-something seconds.
That's a lot of time.
That's a lot of time. It's almost a full round. So they're going to have to really get map control and just push up. And Curse cannot play too defensive on the
flag. First thing Complexity has to do is take out Blindfire. He was the guy that captured the flag. So they're going to know he's got bit of a head start towards some streaks, but I'm going to scroll through these players. Still War Machine ammo left for Complex. Crimsix, he's out of everything.
Yeah, you know, that War Machine could actually prove to be pretty deadly. Even if you have Flak Jacket, it plunges you a little and stops your sprint, but you know, that's two down right off the start for Curse, and they have to be extremely, extremely careful.
But it's going to be TP leads the way. There's the smoke grenade we're going to talk about. And there you go. Takes out Miracles. Trying to stay alive. Finding one more play at the top of the street. Oh, my God. He just destroyed Twins. Going for the flagpole. But they are able to hold on defensively. Big kill coming out of Complex right there.
Yeah, that was a huge kill coming out of Complex. And BL Fire getting back into mid-map, making more huge kills. But, you know, Aix holding down this mid-map with his AR. We're going to see if Complexity can get map control and make another good push on the base again.
But you got to look at that smoke grenade from TP. That's what you need when you want to try to pull the flag out. Unfortunately, there are just too many members from Curse alive at the base, and he wasn't able to get anywhere with that flag. But now you got TP trying to make another play happen. We're going for the pull here. Still getting that smoke grenade out. I'm surprised we haven't seen any trophy systems come out of Curse here to be thrown on their flag.
Yeah, you know, I'm surprised we're not seeing a lot of trophy systems out of Curse. You know, getting a garage one right there, pretty unfortunate for Crim, but Complexity's putting a lot of pressure on the base, Riven. It's never good when we see this much pressure on a team's base. Curse really has to watch themselves.
But Curse, they're doing a good job just holding on to garage. They're not letting anybody from Complexity get inside and gain position there. They always have at least two members around that area of the map. But here we go. They're going to be making another push this time around. They got three around the air. Crim will get taken out, so it's going to be up to Teep. Finds one at the white van, but he's got to wait for his teammate Aix to push up with him.
Yeah, you know, that they're going to have to wait and get their teammates in position to make a push, but if I'm Curse, I'm extremely worrisome that I'm playing a little too defensive right now. On every spawn, you see everybody rotating all back to the flag, and you see two players from Complexity working down Blue Street.
And now Crim, this is the time where he's going to flank around, gets the smoke once again on the flag, but here comes the War Machine from Complex, which is, you know, it's doing a lot of damage to the Complexity guys because they don't want to run Flakjacker right now. They need that lightweight to try to be as quick as on the map as possible. Finds one there on the Twiz. But usually when we see teams make this push around through White Wall, they're also simultaneously being aggressive towards Garage, and they're essentially pinching in on the spawns of their opponent.
Yeah, you know, they kill that guy back Fountain, and now Curse is spawning in front of Blue, and nobody in position to get these cutoffs for Curse. And, you know, there's one guy at the Complexity flag, and that's a huge pull right there.
Uh-oh, Teep, he's got to do some defensive work of his own, but can't defend him there. He gets taken out. Now Twiz, he's away with this flag, and it's looking good. Curse, they are going to take out Complexity one more time in Pro Scrims. They are your winners for tonight, winning the first capture of flag. I mean, they lost raid. They lost standoff, but Slums looks like this is where they bounce back, and they're going to win Pro Scrims.
Yeah, you know, they bounce back, like you said, from losing both those CTFs to bounce back and win this one, especially when it's the last map of the night, when everything decides on this. You know, that's just great play from Kurt.
And now Complexity, they're on a bit of a losing streak in pro scrims. They've lost the last two times they've been on broadcast.
Yeah, you know, they lost both to Kurt, you know. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, just big ups to Kurt. They've been playing great lately. With the addition of Miracles, they've really looking like a team to beat.
Yeah, unfortunately for Kurt, these pro points won't help them earn an invite to the full set invitational. Those invites have already gone out to Complexity, Unite Gaming, Optic Gaming, and FaZe.
Yeah, you know, those. It's unfortunate that Curse didn't earn a spot to be there. You know, I think they would have had to, if they would have beat Optic in the 5K, it would have been a lot closer. They actually probably would have got in, I think, over FaZe. So, you know, it's extremely difficult to lose that type of round, but it happens.
Close games all night long, but in the end, it was Curse Gaming coming out on top. But before we close out the broadcast, if you live around the Orlando area and you want to attend the Full Sail Invitational or spectate it, head over to MajorLeagueGaming.com, go to the shop there, and you could buy a spectator pass. Make sure that you buy one for Saturday if you want to watch Call of Duty Black Ops 2, because that's the day we're on, and Dota 2 is on Friday.
Yeah, and I mean, Full Sail, if you're definitely around in the area, if you want to come spectate four amazing Call of Duty teams, and Dota 2 also looks amazing. Play, I mean, this is the event to be at.
All right, but now, we were talking about an MVP all night long. I think, without a doubt, I'm going to give it to Complex from Curse.
Yeah, I think it has to be Complex from Curse. You know, I think the two biggest rounds of the night were probably the 2-on-1 from Raid and the 2-on-1 from Meltdown. You know, if those searches go the other way, this series is over a while ago.
Yeah, I mean, Meltdown search, that Curse, they only won that because of Complex. And there you go. Take a look at this guy. These were his stats for the night. Went 170, 174, but Killdeath doesn't really mean that one. Yeah. Take a look at the other stats. 23 hardpoint captures, 17 defense, 2 defuses, a plant, 2 flag caps, and 3 returns.
Yeah, I mean, just going huge on hardpoint. I mean, since they've acquired Miracles, he's kind of slid over to be more of their objective player. I mean, you can see that, like, translated in the stats right there.
All right, well, thanks for tuning in for tonight's broadcast. Curse Gaming, they win pro scrims, so they earn 500 pro points each, but still won't help them earn an invite to the Full Sail Invitational. But make sure you tune in this Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern, as we got more pro scrims going down.
Yeah, who do we have on Thursday?
I'm not sure yet.
All right, so we'll find out Thursday.
You want to follow MLG Ron on Twitter. He's the producer of the stream. He'll have all that information before anybody else out there does, so take a look at him on Twitter. But thanks for tuning in here at the New York City Studios for MLG. I'm Revan, that's Mr. X. We'll see you guys Thursday.